just gonna warm up my hands. So do a little bit of sports massage here. I'm just gonna loosen up the leg, the shin, because we're on our feet all the time. Unless you're lazy, you're sitting down. Loosen up the hip flexor. And just connect the whole leg here down to the foot. Thor here, a nice little diaper drape. And I'm just going to warm up my hands. Lots of almond oil. It's good for the tissue, good for the skin, and really cheap at your local Whole Paycheck. Our subject here has some nice defined quads that we're going to loosen up. Effleurage is probably the most common and staple massage strokes out there. We use effleurage in sports massage, deep tissue, Swedish. Kinds of nice knots in this vastus lateralis here. Those nice massage sounds. Just gonna get the blood flow going here. And a little bit of petrissage here. Trying to connect with all parts of the quad. Vastus medialis and inside. Vastus medialis obliquus. And Just kind of feel the separation between the vastus medialis and the adductor magnus tendon, where it comes into the adductor magnus tubercle. Nice and crunchy in there. A lot of biking on these legs here. This is a common area that gets tight for bikers. And then you got sartorius that comes through here. Fun fact, longest muscle in the body, sartorius. Just a nice flat palm here. Flatten out these quad muscles. I'm gonna come in here with a flat forearm. Just smash out that rectus femoris, vastus intermedius. Rectus femoris is one of the four quad muscles, but the only one to attach to the hip. Attaches to that anterior superior iliac crest point, which makes it a hip flexor. A lot of people talk about hip flexors. They usually mean the tensor fascia lata, the TFL, but there are a lot of hip flexors. I'm just trying to stay relaxed here. Just taking my time. Doing some nice steamroller techniques here. Paying attention to our client, seeing if he's tensing up at all. If so, we want to either slow down or back off or both. Since we're doing kind of an ASMR style massage and we're focused on sounds, this isn't typically how I work. Nor do I ever really sound like this, but I hope you're enjoying it. We're just doing some compression on the tibialis anterior here, taking my thumb, taking my palm, and smashing that down. It makes it very easy for me to give a lot of pressure, and it's easy for me and easy on me. We can do some thumb on thumb. Trigger point work there. On that beefy part of the tibialis anterior. Tibialis anterior is one of your stirrup muscles. Stirrup meaning helping stabilize the ankle along with the peroneus longus. Tibialis anterior is used a lot because it's a dorsal flexor. Helps bring your toes towards your head. Helps bring it up and invert your ankle. And since we walk a lot, we walk heel to toe, which means we use our tibialis anterior a lot. Lots of almond oil makes this sound really good for you ASMR lovers. on the Lithuanian speed walking team. And the size of their tibialis anterior, their shin muscles, were gigantic. Because in speed walking, you have to keep one foot down on the ground at all times. So they use heel to toe more than anybody I've ever seen. Alright, let's work this quad a little bit. We're gonna just do a little separation of the quad muscles. I'm just going to come in here between that rectus femoris and vastus lateralis and split those muscles apart. They get pretty sticky. That's where I'll find a lot of fascial adhesions. I like to use a thumb-on-thumb technique. You can go one thumb, but your thumbs will probably fall off when you get old. Also come in here with an elbow, nice and slow. Our subject bikes a lot and mountain bikes a lot, so his quads are really tight, so we gotta be careful, diligent. We don't want any screaming for this ASMR videos or any laughing either. And a little petrissage. Come down to the shin. Work that peroneus longus, the other stirrup muscle. If you know your anatomy at all, there's two other peroneal muscles. There's peroneus longus, but there's also peroneus brevis and peroneus tertius, which are down at the end of the ankle, usually very tender. We'll hit a little bit of the IT band, and still working that vastus lateralis. I could probably spend a whole hour on this muscle on most of my clients. For deep tissue, it works really well to slow your work down. Follow the muscle as far as you can, all the way up into that tensor fasciae lata, which is the origin of the IT band. So if you didn't know, the IT band goes all the way up to your hip and all the way down to your tibia. Attaches to the tibial plateau. IT band is just a thick piece of connective tissue. It's not a tendon. It doesn't contract. It's mostly there to protect. This deep prep stuff. When you put it on dry skin, it's really good for deep tissue. It's really good for fascia, myofascial release. it's commonly used, the technique called Graston or intramuscular assisted soft tissue manipulation. But it probably sounds really good for ASMR. Separate that IT band a little bit from that vastus lateralis, looking for those adhesions, trying to get some of those muscle twitches. This is pretty intense work. Client is a pretty tough guy, so that's why he's on here. Since we're all quarantined and isolated, I can take my stress out on my client here. Smash his quad to death while you guys fall asleep. I love this thumb-on-thumb technique. We can always go back to the elbow. I just lean into the table, just hang out here, and wait for those twitches. It's always good to take a deep breath. You and your client. Some ISTM, intramuscular assisted soft tissue manipulation. There is a company called Graston that certifies practitioners to do this. There's also something called Gua Sha. It's been around for a long time. It's just great. Get some extra hyperemia, some blood flow to break up the adhesions. Also happens to be pretty good for ASMR sounds. You can see we've got some capillaries breaking there, so we've got a good response. Once you start getting that response, you can move on to another spot. And if you're going to be entering into any leg competitions, any leg modeling, I would not get this treatment before that. for separating muscles. Sometimes people have super tight hips. You can see this gap here. So you can support that with your hand or put another pillow under there. And we're just gonna work his pes anserinus muscles, adductors, sartorius, vastus medialis. Pes anserinus muscles are three muscles that attach on the pes anserinus. Made up of sartorius, semitendinosus, which is a hamstring muscle, and gracilis, which is an adductor, but also a hip flexor. I'm just separating these muscles. Typically a very tender area. Just gonna connect everything, flush everything out towards the heart. I don't know about you, but I wish I was on the table getting this massage. How many massages has this guy gotten?